All right, what's going on, everybody? This is your boy Phil here.
And I'm Sam.
And he's playing a game while we're trying to do a movie review.
I just gotta collect some letters and then...
All right, so for today's review, we're gonna be reviewing the movie Stuck in Love.
Watching my ex-wife's new life is like turning on a familiar sitcom and realizing they had replaced one of the lead actors with a younger, dumber model.
Down! Down! Heel!
My book's being published.
Congratulations.
Thank you. God.
Congratulations.
Your sister is a great writer, and it's because she's courageous in her life.
We both want to go back to your room, have sex, and never see each other again.
She's promiscuous, Dad. That's not the same thing.
Okay, so basically the synopsis is, an acclaimed writer, his ex-wife, and their teenage children come to terms with the complexities of love and all its forms over the course of one tumultuous year. So basically, this movie is about, you know, a family dealing with love.
Yeah.
And, you know, from their personal sides and from a family side. And,
Yeah, that's right. I didn't really connect that. Yeah.
And, we saw this at the Phoenix Film Festival. It was the last showing there, I believe. And it was actually our first time. You've never been there before.
No, I've never been there.
Yeah, so it was our first time there, and it was a really good experience.
Yeah,
the audience was awesome.
Yeah,
they all like enjoyed the movie and everything. So that's what made the movie, you know, a lot better than it was.
Yeah, everyone was really polite. It's crazy.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, if you go to a normal theater, they're just like, move, move. You know what I mean? But everyone there, like, everyone was talking, and they were just like, hey. What do you do?
Right.
What is that guy doing? I was like, I don't know.
Yeah, at the end of the movie, I felt something on my feet. And I was like, what the? And there's some guy shining my shoes.
Yeah, right?
It was crazy.
All right, yeah. So like he said, they're a family of writers, which is cool. Dad's a writer. Daughter's a writer.
Mm-hmm.
The son's a writer. The mom,
a painter?
She's a painter.
Yeah.
Okay, like that's an art. Greg Kinnear's the dad.
Yeah.
And then the daughter, I don't know the daughter.
Daughter Lily Collins.
Lily Collins.
Yes. I just remember she was in one... movie about her like having powers. I don't know what movie it was though. Was it the Creatures? No, that's a different girl.
Beautiful Creatures, right?
Beautiful Creatures? No, that's a different girl, I think.
Oh, I don't know.
Anyways, she had powers. The son was Nat Wolff.
I heard that name before.
I remember him being in some like Nickelodeon stuff.
Really?
Yeah, but he was actually pretty good in this movie.
No, he was good. Yeah.
We'll get to that though when we talk about the acting. Mm. And the wife, Jennifer Connelly, I remember she was in the first Hulk movie.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, another movie she was in.
Yeah, she was in A Beautiful Mind with Russell Crowe.
Of course.
I actually don't really care for her usually.
Yeah.
I don't really like Jennifer Connelly, but this movie.
She looks annoying to me.
Yeah, right?
Yeah.
Dude, there's something, and honestly, it sounds weird. I think it's the brows, man.
Her brows?
Her brows, bro.
I mean, her acting's alright, you know. Her stage presence is good, but those eyebrows.
Those damn brows.
Yeah, okay.
But she was good in this movie. Yeah,
Yeah, she didn't do bad. She wasn't that annoying.
Yeah, she didn't have that much to do, really.
That's because I kind of felt bad for her.
Yeah, felt bad for her eyebrows.
We'll get to that in the story part. Another big star, and it was Logan Lerman.
Yeah.
He wasn't actually that much in the movie as I thought he was going to be.
I was hoping for more.
Yeah, me too. Because after The Perks of Being a Wallflower, come on.
Right.
After Percy Jackson, come on.
Dude, Percy Jackson 2, come on.
I wanted to see him on the screen more because he just, you know, has an awesome presence when he acts and everything like that, so... Yes.
Yeah, he has good eyebrows.
The next star in it, I don't know why she was like totally like credited in this movie, but Kristen Bell.
Yeah, I actually totally forgot about that. Yeah.
Yeah, she didn't need to be in this movie.
Same with Saving That Guaranteed.
That's true.
She kind of sneaks in these little indie movies.
That's right, man. That's right.
We forgot about Sarah Marshall already. You don't need to keep coming back.
Yeah, there was a bunch of other, you know, people and everything, but those were the main actors that you had to pay attention to and that, you know, made the movie what it was. And what it was a piece of good stuff. All right, so the story. Yeah, so it basically, it had to do with them dealing with love and their situations. The dad was getting over his ex-wife and, you know, their divorce and everything like that and trying to move on. The son was dealing with, you know, new love in a way and everything. And then the daughter was dealing with, you don't learn till the end of the, or till some, we'll get into the spoilers later, but like why she has love issues and trust issues and stuff, but she just deals with that. And then the ex-wife, like the mom, I guess she's trying to deal with their divorce too.
Yeah, like, cause she goes to like a different younger guy. What I liked, is how it deals with writers. And the dad was an acclaimed writer, so the daughter, who was also a good writer, didn't want to follow in his shadow, really, wanted to make her own thing. And then the son's dealing with the pressure of trying to be a writer.
Yeah.
And he does, you could tell he's kind of uncomfortable with it, like, am I a writer? Am I mm-hmm. supposed to be a writer?
Yeah.
And coming from someone who loved writing, mm-hmm. it was really cool. Nice. To see them
deal with definitely. That. Yeah, they didn't push on it too much.
No, yeah.
It was a good amount of dealing with that kind of situation and everything. Mm-hmm. Structurally wise, I guess, it wasn't, it was pretty simple.
It was a really simple
movie. Mm-hmm. But it's a story that definitely, got the audience.
The movie was pretty good paced, but it kind of dragged.
Yeah, there was a point in the movie where it was only 90 minutes, which is not a long time at all.
But it felt longer than 90 minutes.
It did. I don't know how they did that.
I don't know. I was even thinking that too, how was this 90 minutes? Was it really 90 minutes?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah.
92 minutes.
Okay.
Who's counting right?
That's why. Those 2 damn minutes were so exactly. long.
For me, at least, it was just people's situations. The character, the daughter, I wanted to see more of her relationship.
Yeah.
With Logan Lerman.
The Lerman.
Exactly. And then there was times where I wanted to see more of the son's story. Mm-hmm. That Nat guy with, his girlfriend. And then there was times, I don't know, I didn't really care too much about the dad's story or side too much. But I loved the chemistry of the family, though.
Yeah, they were good.
They knew each other, so well. They were, rude to each other when they had to be, real with each other, polite with each other. And it was a good... it was a good relationship with them.
A good dysfunctional family.
Oh, yeah, yeah. And I love the dad's attitude.
Yeah.
He was great.
He was a great in the air, man. He was really good.
Yeah, he was awesome. Yeah, the relationship he had with his kids, it was really cool.
Yeah.
Because he trusted them, but he was still their father.
Yeah.
He wasn't just just let them, do whatever they want kind of thing. He was kind of actually pushing that in a way.
Yeah.
For their writing.
Yeah, he wanted them to be writers, which was crazy because, he tells him, keep a journal. As long as you keep keeping a journal, I'll pay for everything.
Right, yeah.
And I'm like, whoa, we gotta write that down, show that to my dad. Logan Lerman and the daughter, I like their story a lot.
Yeah.
And I actually did, I was interested in Greg Kinnear's, and the son was kind of on the bottom. But I still wanted to see more.
Yeah, see more butts.
See more butts. I think when it dragged, I don't know why, I don't know. It just dragged.
It was in the third act of the movie, I guess. If you count 4 acts. Yeah. Yeah. It was around the third part of the movie where it started slowing down in a way. And that's when you kind of felt all right, this movie just needs to get, a little better.
Yeah.
Or something needs to happen.
It just needs to, move on. I guess they could have skipped over a few things, but I don't know.
The first shot of the movie, they're in a classroom, and then that one Nat kid, the son, he's looking at this girl, and she's asleep. But her nose is bleeding, and that was one of the coolest shots too. And you were saying about the text, how it was written.
They're talking in their head, what is that, inner monologue?
Mm-hmm.
And but the text is showing up on the screen, which is pretty cool. I haven't seen that done probably in a while.
Yeah.
I've probably never seen that done before.
But it's actually funny, because that's the only time they did it in the movie.
Yeah, and I kind of thought they're going to keep going with that.
Yeah.
Their experiences are good. They're going to be writing their experience they had at the end of the movie or something like that. But they didn't. I kind of wish they did that more of that or something like that.
Yeah.
Maybe not have that ending, but more of the text.
So there was a scene in the bar, or in a bar, where Lily Collins, she's talking to some one guy, and it's like an opening scene for her part of the story, and she's talking all big words and stuff. Mm-hmm. It kind of sounded like she was talking something out of a book. It didn't sound natural at all.
Yeah.
So that was kind of getting me a little iffy, this is her character and everything. But as the story progresses, she gets better.
Yeah.
More believable, more trustworthy, and you want to stick with her for the rest of the movie. Plus, she's not a bad girl to look at.
So Logan Lerman, right?
Yes.
Yeah, he did good. He played another writer and stuff like that.
Oh yeah, that was pretty cool.
Yeah, that was cool. Yeah, and his love interest is the daughter, and he did good. He's a good actor.
Yeah, he's such a likable character in anything.
Yeah, anything he does. Even when I don't like him, I actually do.
It's true.
Everyone did really good, actually, for what they were working with. The soundtrack to this movie was really good. The opening song, dude, what song? That was a really good song.
That was the same song they played in the car scene, right?
No.
No?
It's like a fast-paced song. They have some of my favorite artists. They have Bright Eyes in it, and then Bon Iver, Elliot Smith, and Elliot Smith between the bars, it's such a great scene when you see it. I always want to put that in a movie.
Yeah.
Yeah. Nice. I would have used it a little differently than how they use it, but it's still really good. It's a beautiful scene.
All right, so now we're going to talk about, I guess, spoilers. There was really, I mean, I don't want to spoil it. I guess there's a really huge twist in the movie. I don't know if that's a spoiler already there. Because it's just a pretty basic movie. But yeah, we're just going to talk about scenes that were in it that if you haven't seen the movie, you should probably watch it first before you watch the rest of this review. I don't know when it's going to be a wide release because I know that it was
premiered here. Oh, we were actually the first people to see it in the U.S.
Yes. So yeah, we're going to get into these scenes. So if you haven't seen it, please go watch it. If you don't care, then please go watch it. One of the scenes that I really enjoyed, besides the first scene, was the car scene when they were inside the car. Yeah. And he was playing the song for Lily Collins. I'm talking about Logan Lerman. And she starts crying and stuff, and then she says, just like, I don't want to be hurt, and he's like, you know, I won't hurt you, and that was a beautiful scene.
That was great. Yeah, especially that's when they use the Elliott Smith song, and it's so good.
Mm-hmm. I really like the part where Logan Lerman calls Lily Collins, she's in bed.
Oh, yeah.
And I don't know what book she's reading, but, wait, she's not reading a book, she's asleep.
Oh, yeah, that's right, she's asleep. Yeah.
And Logan Lerman calls her and says that, you know, his mom died, and that actually got me pretty teary-eyed, that was really good.
Yeah, it'll pull your heartstrings, this movie.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah. Lily Collins in the movie gets her book published, and later on it tells her her age, and she's 19.
That's right.
Book published as 19, it's crazy. Mm-hmm. Like, that's insane.
Yeah. You know
what I mean? And for a book like that to, like, appeal to, like, older people.
Yeah.
That's really cool.
Out of 10, what do you give it?
I don't know. Probably 8.
An 8?
Yeah. I would say 7, but that seems low. That seems like I didn't really like it that much.
Yeah. You noticed when you said I was still doing the drum roll?
I know, right? Okay. Please go on.
I'm not done yet.
I'll probably give it an 8 out of 10.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Probably, 8.5 I would get, because it wasn't like a perfect movie, but it was like good enough where I would be interested in buying it. Like, I would be interested in seeing it again because it just had good feelings to it. And not only that, but the audience in the movie theater made everything, you know, feel good too. You know, just the excitement of the Phoenix Film Festival. Yeah, that was, it was really cool. So it was a really good experience, and it was an enjoyable movie. So yeah, definitely go check it out.
Great movie, check it out, Stuck in Love. I don't know when it's gonna be released, but check it out.
Mm-hmm.
Hope you enjoyed the review.
Should have.
If not, just keep it to your damn self.
That's the truth.
And that's it. I'm Sam Santana.
I'm Phil Ramirez. The trailer and synopsis will be in the description. Tell us what you think about this movie. We're out. Thanks for watching.
Can I stay at your house tonight?
Okay.
Dude!
I knew you were cynical about love.
You make me feel less cynical. I have days when I'm not sure I made the right decision.
About us, our story, and all the things that went wrong with us, and I could do it so much better this time.
I need you, and that song.
I could hear everyone's heart. I could hear the human noise we sat there making. Not one of us moving, not even when the room went dark.